Victor here.
All right, you got legal questions. You don't want me or Cody answering them, so we have Dan Del Rio from Del Rio and Caraway here, an actual licensed attorney here to take us through some of this. Good morning. Thanks for being with us. Chuck couldn't be here. He's actually in court.
That's true.
Doing lawyer stuff. All right, so an interesting story going on right now with these Apple AirTags. People use them. You know, you can put them on your luggage, you can put them on your pets, all kinds of places. But then there are nefarious uses. Apparently stalkers have been using them, and now this is leading to some legal issues.
Yeah, it's an interesting problem because they're meant to be discreet. They're meant to be, you know, to give you the ability to track things. That's what their purpose is. But of course, that has a nefarious use also. So people are, because they're so discreet, I mean, you can get cases for them that can hide them anywhere. They have magnetic cases, mm-hmm. so you can attach them to anything. So there's all these things. And of course, you know, there's good uses. We use them for bathroom keys in the office. Mm-hmm. So, hey, where's the bathroom key? Oh, look, track, there it is, got left at someone's desk. You know, so they have a good purpose. The problem is the bad purposes are there too. And the bad purposes are a big deal because until recently when Apple added the technology to be able to warn you that you may be being tracked if it's around you for too long, there was no way to know. I mean, they're so small, it's so discreet, it's really easy to get away with. Even with this, the advocates are basically saying that these tools have too much potential for danger. Even with the potential warning that you can get, it's just, they've been used to actually go ahead and stalk people, and it's just, there's enough danger out there that there needs to be more safety mechanisms put in place.
Let me play the role of opposing counsel here. Couldn't Apple just say, like, we made a good product, people can use, like, you know, knives can be used to slice tomatoes or humans. Like, how are we responsible for that?
So that's exactly it. Is they're saying they're not responsible for misuse.
Yeah.
If it's beyond the intention, if it's beyond the expectation, the argument on the other side is, well, reasonably you should have expected maybe that a device that's used to track could be used to track for good or bad. And so you need to put in more things specifically.
Okay, so there, I want to go back to, remember back in the NFL playoffs, there was that Kansas City Chiefs-Miami Dolphins game where it was 7 below 0 or something. Apparently some Dolphins fans, maybe not used to it, suffered frostbite, things like that.
Yeah.
Do they, can they sue the Chiefs? Can they sue the NFL? Can they sue anybody? Is there anybody responsible for this?
Well, it's interesting because it actually, I mean, it was as soon as the game was over, some people were hospitalized.
Yeah.
So this was obvious. And there's some statistic now that it sounds like from the local burn center that like 70% of the people that were referred for frostbite burns are now actually looking at amputation. So it's not like it's a small problem at all. What is coming up is that the NFL has standards for severe weather. And if severe weather events happen, they cancel or postpone games. Mm-hmm. But usually we're talking about things like hurricanes, thunder, lightning, things where there's, you know, imminent harm happening. There is no standard or threshold for extreme heat or extreme cold. Mm-hmm. They just haven't had it enough. And so this kind of brings up the idea of, is this an issue of the local club where they should say, hey, I'm here in Chicago, wherever, and we deal with this, so we are going to make a local standard? Or is this something that the NFL needs to look at overall? Mm-hmm. Because neither one has it at the moment.
Yeah.
There's local rules for snow removal, but there's no local rules for extreme heat, extreme cold. We have this here in California. I mean, we cancel high school games if they get over a certain temperature.
Yeah.
That's for protection of the players. It's also for protection of the fans, the whole thing. But that's a local rule. No one has made this as an industry-wide thing for the NFL yet. And yes, now we're looking at situations where you're going to have extreme damages.
Yeah, maybe the top league in the country should come up with something. Okay, running short on time, but I want to get to this last one. Case in Oakland, people riding public transit. There's an accident, I think 16 people injured, so, you know. What's the liability situation there?
So this is always difficult. I hate to look at situations like this, but a car basically loses control, clips another car, hits a bus. So the bus, as far as we know right now, is not at fault. The bus is merely a victim, but unfortunately a victim that has a lot of victims within it. And of course, the hard situation with buses, no seatbelts, all this kind of stuff. The difficulty is that this is all going to be on that car that essentially started it. And if you look at this situation, there's almost no way you cut it, but one person and their basic insurance against, unfortunately, 16 injured individuals, it's not going to be a good situation.
Interesting. All right, Dan Del Rio from Del Rio and Caraway, thank you so much. We
appreciate
it. All right, guys.
Come in. All right.